Look at the Best Buy Black Series Star Wars 6-inch scale IG-11 from The Mandalorian. IG-11 stands at just under 7 inches, 6.5 inches tall, or about 16 centimetres. It is a repaint of the previous both archive and original Black Series figure. And it's a little bit of a lazy remake, but we'll get in, we'll get a look at it in just a minute. On the packaging, you can see, again, Gregory Titus's artwork on there, looking pretty good. Let me just put some more lights on. And nicely done, and again, nothing else really. Star Wars The Black Series, it's a Best Buy exclusive in the US, and currently has not made its way, way anywhere else in the world, which is a real sad shame for Hasbro, because they've given an exclusive to a store that's frankly a bit kind of crap. Is geo-restricted, and it's kind of useless because they've already put the damn thing in sale and it's barely out, so that was a waste of time and money, I think. Anyway, we'll put a link in the description below where you can hopefully pick it up and get it shipped to you. IG-11 there, some text. Basically one of the IG series of droids, and again, some nice Gregory Titus artwork in the back. Don't stick it up your nose in multiple languages. And there we go, UPC should you need it. So, it is a direct repaint with a very few extras added on to the figure. But let's zoom in just a little bit and we'll get a much closer look at this figure. Let me just zoom in here. Alright, let's have a look at him. So, we get some nice paint, and the newest addition, the key one here, is this belt, which is a little bit, it should actually be a little bit higher. Like that, but it's kind of sloppy the way it's been done, but there you go. We've got this belt with all his ammo packs on here, and that is kind of glued together down at that piece down there. Really heavily stuck together. It's got mines on the back, and a slot for which looks like this small blaster, which we'll get to in a minute, but that can slot in. Well, that doesn't even slot in very well. Really? Maybe it's the longer weapon? Yeah, it is. There you go. So that fits in there. Actually quite nice. That holster's pretty good. That's a nice change. Sadly though, IG-11 is quite different to IG that we know. And for one thing that's kind of different, the body part down here is very different round about the waist. The rest of it is not too radical, and the head is the same pretty much, but it's the hands. IG-11 has kind of claws, like multiple 3 or 4 fingers, basically. It's not really kind of going on here for Iggy here. So either way, look, you can't blame Hasbro, I guess, in one way doing a repaint, but it just would have been nice to make some tweaks to it. This really should be a copper colour, so it's not the right colour here, according to some of the shots and watching The Mandalorian again. But the body's pretty accurate. It's a much lighter colour overall, but you can see the difference once I compare. You know, they never really got this right. This is the archive edition, and they sprayed it all gold, and because the first one was too dark, and it just, yeah, it's never really been right, and it's definitely worth a complete retool. And you can see under the body and under all the belts and bandoliers, etc., it's the same body, same parts, same everything. Now, I am rather told by some people, and not that I really noticed, but the legs in the first release, some people said they had a shorter leg on their IG figure. Mine still has that. On this one, it's a little better, but apparently the legs were slightly modified, but frankly I never really noticed much difference. The legs still feel way too close for me, especially when you see some of the shots of IG-11. His legs are really designed, or should be designed, to be much wider apart, and you can't because he's on a swivel, so he's not going anywhere. There's no extension to the leg. So apart from that, again, direct repaint, not a great deal of additions to it, basically the bandolier, and that's about it. But nice feature on the holster. This original one here, they never really got a chance to get right on the 3.75 inch scale, I always remember that, but they did correct it for the 6 inch, which is nice. So, you know, not too bad. On the archive release, we did get just solid black weapons and nothing to write home about. This time, we do get much better looking weapons overall. And they're much more chromed up. Let me just zoom this here. And you can see all the kind of chroming that they've added on top of the weapon, which really adds a nice shine to it, which is needed. I mean, at least you've bought the same damn figure, a base again. So at least to add some chrome in the blasters is a nice touch. The same for the rifle, which we've had before with Stormtroopers. And again, depending upon the figure and how much sculpting and so forth goes into it, if it's a repaint, they'll generally at least try and update the weapons and put a paint on them. But they've done a good job there. It's pretty reasonable. Looks quite gun-like, which is nice. And the rest of the figure, well, I mean, same articulation. You get a swivel head up at the top here. It looks as if it would swivel up further up, but it doesn't. And again, some nice wash and chrome throughout the rest of the figure and the detail there. Arms, same as the previous IGU release, and you can see that articulation as well underneath there as I move that down. See that little hinge that moves down? That's your upper ab, basically. So you do get some articulation, but he's just not going to be in that position, so it's kind of redundant, I would have thought. And again, you've got the belt there, obviously, going to stop that. You've then got further upper ab crunch rotation up at the top. So you can play around and get some kind of different poses. But then it's the legs, and that's the problem that we get, is you really can't do much with this. And as you try and stretch the leg, well, you've got this giant pipe here, and that's going to stop you. So you can't really get too far. As you can see, there's a joint there at the knee too, but it's just limited. So, you know, what are you going to do with them articulation-wise? You're limited. And then on the other leg, same pipe there, which is going to stop you. We do get... camera's just not behaving here. We do get these pretty cool ankles with these feet, which does allow a bit of movement, but there's no side-to-side, really. So tell lie that it's side-to-side. My apologies, I forgot that it's side-to-side there. And shallowish peg holes, which are a bit rubbish. He always falls over because he's just so tall. The issue, the real issue that I wanted to highlight to you was these rubbery little parts here on the elbows. Now, if you remember me doing the archive release review, I compared and showed the original IG figure, and what has happened to these is they have corroded. They're small rubberized pieces on these figures, and they've still not corrected them, which means this will go first on your figure, and I had to remove them. And actually, in some ways, it kind of improves the articulation, because then you can bend without this kind of coil effect here, and it kind of helps the figure overall. But they will corrode, so yeah, be warned. And then when it gets down to the wrists, there's no articulation, but what it does have is a slot for... A lot of people didn't know this, but you have a slot on the side of this blaster. See the tiny hole? That plugs in to this hand. Was it designed for that? Yeah, I'm sure it was. Maybe it was that hand. Designed for that hand, my apologies. And this one is designed for this hand. There we go. Yes, that's correct. So there you go. A peg for each one, and that allows the IG-11 to hold the blasters. So there you go. It's kind of... it's a wee pain, you know. Just annoying, but there you go. That's what it is. So, a pretty reasonable figure. It's okay if you've not got the previous release, but most of us got the archive release. So, yeah, and it just never stands up. It's terrible for standing up, which is why we need stands, but I can't even be bothered. Anyway, it's a pretty okay figure. Exclusive, kind of hard to get, so don't pay a lot of money for it. Again, it's already down to like $15 in Best Buys. Let us know what you think. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up, and we will see you for the next Black Series and other figure reviews coming right up. Cheers.